Here we are. We're still waiting on Rebecca's team for reCAPTCHA information. This is what'll validate our forms to help reduce spam. So we'll cover that later during our review. But now, responsive testing and adjustments for our contact page on desktop, tablet, mobile landscape, and mobile portrait. This is really important, especially to Rebecca and the team at Hayes Valley, because this was a weak point, a challenging part of their old design in which people couldn't easily navigate the site and get in touch when they viewed it on smaller devices. People who visited the old site had an intention, but the obstacle was that it was clunky and weird on mobile devices. So it's our job to bring as much value to every page, of course, but especially to the page that'll be part of potential clients reaching out to their team. So let's get started on desktop. Things on desktop, as we just designed, look pretty good, maybe a little bit narrow here. So we could grab our contact details and edit that parent grid. Since this grid is only being used in one place, changes to it won't affect others. But if we realize the contact grid isn't what's creating the separation. So let's actually press done there and select the grid inside the grid, contact details. Let's edit that grid. And we can decrease this one a little bit, maybe to 0.5 FR, 0.75 FR might be fine. That looks pretty good. Let's hit done. And let's test responsiveness. Let's test fluidity on this. That looks pretty good. Something to note about the content there is we're widening. We can test and validate that this has been formatted correctly. It hasn't. Let's grab that and knock it down to a new line. That address is more correctly formatted. Floor is hanging over, so it might be worth making that last adjustment, bringing this down to 0.5 or even 0.6. Nope. 0.5. There we go. Let's see how that looks. If we grab the edge, that looks pretty good. What about the space between this, the plain hero section, and the contact section? Could we reduce the padding on the top to about 30? How does that look? Not that much different. Still enough white space. Seems that contact our team is a little bit better in terms of vertical centering away from this between the nav bar, this text, and then this text, and contact text. So that's looking pretty good. Everything else looks good on desktop. Let's move on to tablet. Now, tablet also scales nicely. The location is a little cramped, and for this reason, and maybe this reason alone, we might want to consider grabbing at least the contact details, editing that, and instead of doing two columns, let's delete one of the columns. This will stack the information like this. Now, client project detail. We used this on another page. We might even want to rename it so it's just label detail. And we can create a combo class here. Let's say no left padding, because this one's not going to have left padding. It's 10, let's make it 0. That looks fine. Let's make sure to apply that combo class to each of these. So because we've applied this combo class, it's not going to negatively affect. It's not going to mess with our design on other pages. The other thing to note is the contact details, this inflated row gap, the gap between the rows, that's a little heavy. So we could grab that and drop it to 15 or so, or maybe even 5. Let's hit done. That looks a lot better. And the label detail, because we created a combo class, we can also apply some margin to the bottom of that without affecting any of the other pages. Let's do 30 pixels here. That looks a little bit better. So if we test fluidity, but tablet is looking pretty good as well. Let's move on to mobile landscape. We're getting a little more cramped. A two-column layout, at least for this content, might not be practical, but there are two parts of that. One, remember, contact section, just like our other sections, we end up reducing the available padding inside. So let's decrease the padding to 15. 15 looks pretty good on this. And in that case, it looks good, but when we get narrow, it pushes some of that content to the next page. We could grab the label detail, and we could decrease that size slightly. Still make it legible on mobile devices. It's a little more friendly. We could go into contact section, reduce this. We have this column gap. We could drop that to about 15. Let's try 15. Let's hit done. Not bad. It's a little narrow. Maybe 30 was more practical here. The two-column layout is pretty tight. So in the interest of legibility and navigability, let's grab the contact section and delete one of these columns. So that'll knock the rest of the content down. That's a lot better. We have enough breathing room here so it doesn't seem too constricted, constrained. You have enough breathing room to type a full name, to type an email address, to type out a message, and to clearly see the submit button. As for the contact details, let's go in here. We could edit this, but actually, it looks fine. Maybe on mobile landscape, since we have some limited real estate, we could reduce the bottom margin on label detail, make that 15. That looks better. Left alignment might work well for this. We could center align this content. Just grab contact details and just center the text. That could work too. We have a lot of the same information here that we do in our footer, but that's not a bad thing. People who come to this contact page are expecting in the body of this page, maybe not even in the footer, this type of information, so that's okay. We could add a little more space underneath, maybe 30 pixels on the bottom for that extra breathing room. This looks pretty good. Let's test fluidity. Everything scales nicely. All right, that's mobile landscape, mobile portrait. There might not be anything to do here. This is one of those rare times where no adjustments are necessary. We could, on the plain hero section, reduce this on the top, but this would affect other pages too, and 30 looks pretty good. We could reduce some of the padding here. Maybe from 20, we could drop it to 15, but now we're really nitpicking, which is not a bad thing. But let's try dropping this to 10. That's pretty good. So mobile landscape is looking excellent. Now, it might be a little weird. It might be a little weird because the hero paragraph is at 15 and this content is so small, it's at 13. Let's go back to mobile landscape because we originally made the change. We switched this to 13 because we wanted to try to fit it in a two column layout. But that's not necessary anymore. So let's try removing that size and looking at mobile portrait. That looks a little bit better. Does it get a little scrunched? Yes, but the way we solved this on other pages was we reduced or removed the padding entirely. Holding down shift, removing it on all four sides at once. That way we have some more breathing room. And that's good. On the narrowest devices, if someone were to browse with 240 pixels of width, then the word floor would get knocked to the next line. There's nothing wrong with that. So that's it. That's the last part of making the contact page responsive. The great thing now is we can take all our hard work, especially the contact form itself, and implement this. We can get a version of this on every page. So it's really clear and easy for people visiting the site to get in touch with Hayes Valley Interior Design. So we'll do that and we'll revisit the homepage in the next video.